Hello, I am Mike from SurgTech Academy, and today I'm going to demonstrate a few skills I call second skills or accessory skills. The reason I call them second skills is because they only take a second to complete. Today I'm going to cover loading and unloading a scalpel blade, loading a suture for a right-handed surgeon, constructing a sponge stick, and filling an asepto. Now normally I would be sterile as I perform these skills. I would be gowned and gloved, etc. But today, for education purposes, I'm going to demonstrate these unsterilely. Now, a couple of things to remember with the scalpel, that'll be our first skill, is that there is a ridge on the scalpel blade. I mean, we can see that ridge right there. And it's used to insert the blade. The second thing I want you to notice is that the angle of the blade matches the angle of the knife handle. It coincides. Now, I know a lot of hospitals are using safety blades now, which I think is great. That method is certainly safer, but this method is for those that aren't using safety blades, which for me is most of Iowa. So, using your right hand, take the needle holder and grasp the blade at the top with the sharp side facing to the left. With your left hand, position the knife blade so that it's angled up and that the angle matches the angle. Carefully fit the blade into the groove and extend or slide the blade down following the ridge of the needle holder until you hear a click. Ooh, good. So I want to show you that again. So I'm going to grasp the blade. The sharp end is facing to the left. Angle matches the angle. I'm going to fit the blade into the ridge. Slowly slide it on until I hear the click. Ah, such a great sound, isn't it? Now I'm going to show you how to remove the blade. So pointing the blade down, super important. I'm going to ratchet the blade at the end, slightly lift the blade off the knife handle and push it away. Perfect. Now, sometimes it's easier for students to move the knife handle upside down because they think they see more of the blade that way. So I'm going to go ahead and show you that technique too. I'm going to put the blade back on. Now from the backside, I suppose they can see a little more blade. Ratchet the needle holder onto the knife blade, pull down, and that's removed. And that, my friends, is loading and unloading a knife handle. So our second demonstration is going to be loading a suture for a right-handed surgeon. I think it's easiest to load the suture as we would in the clinical setting, with the suture still in the packet. Now, some students perform this a bunch of times, and I'll show you how to perform that skill after we take the suture out of the packet. So first, let's grab the needle holder using our ring finger and our thumb and only loading it at the first digit. We're going to grasp the needle holder. Now it's super difficult if you bury this instrument in your hand to maneuver it. So make sure that you only put it on the first knuckle. So laying the suture flat on your Mayo stand or back table, come down flat with your palm, with your palm down and the back of your hand up. Once you come down, grab the suture, ratchet it so you hear clicks, and go ahead and pull out. And that is what I would call a perfectly loaded stitch. Now, there is a way we can do this not by wasting a ton of suture. So we start it with on our back table, all right? So you want to make sure that the needle starts as a smiley face and that the suture trails off to the right. Now, some students believe that it's easier to do the palm up. I think it's best to do palm down. So again, with smiley face, stitch string going to the right, come down at about 30 degrees, 1/3 of the way down on the needle, ratchet, and there we have a perfectly loaded stitch. Now I know some surgeons like their needles at 90 degrees, all right? Some like them at 45 degrees. However they like it, go ahead and do that. I tell my students about 30 degrees. Now, with students and new people that want to practice that multiple times, that's the way you would do that outside of the package. All right, next, second skill. is we're going to construct a sponge stick. I've seen this done a bunch of different ways, and I'm going to show you two of those ways. But first, I'm going to show you the way that I think is best. So the first method for constructing a sponge stick is the way I teach my students. And the reason I like this is because it covers the entire end of the ring forceps, and I think it provides the least chance for tissue damage. The first step is probably the most important. You need to start your sponge in a diamond shape, not in a square. Fold the bottom third of the sponge up, place your sponge forceps in the middle, and start folding the sides in. And that is a sponge stick. Now, some SurgTechs think the second method is way faster and tighter, but again, I've never really timed it. And basically, this method is you fold the sponge into thirds, fold it in half, and then load it onto your sponge forceps that way. Now, again, I've never timed it. I don't know which way is faster, but I do like the first method better, strictly because all of the metal is completely covered. And if the surgeon is one of those surgeons that really likes to dissect, I like having all the metal of the sponge forceps covered. Now, our last second skill filling up an asepto. This is a skill we do every single day. So we have our saline in our pitcher. Simply squeeze the bulb, insert the tip into the saline, release, and lift. The key is not to splash all over your back table or all over your circulator. Unless you're a little passive aggressive and want to splash your circulator, then maybe that'll be okay. But here at SurgTech Academy, we don't advocate splashing the back table or our circulators. Now, for my students to pass this second skill test out, all right, they have to make sure that the saline is to the tip of the asepto. And once that is, that's a perfectly loaded asepto. Now, bulb syringes are done in the same manner. You have to be a little more careful because you can't see the saline in the bulb syringe, but still the same steps. So there you have it, all of our second skills. Loading and unloading a scalpel blade, loading a stitch, constructing a sponge stick, and filling up an asepto. So please subscribe to my SurgTech Academy channel. I want you to have a great day in surgery, and remember, be a superstar in your OR.